marriage and beyond togetherness. Human relation is a very delicate phenomenon, and each relationship is the way for the continuation of soul's journey. Why do two people come together? Along with the physical aspect, this journey is for the continuation of the soul's journey. Evolving out of the womb of unconscious and subconscious, it journeys towards fruition. When two people meet one another, they develop an attraction. We do not know why we feel attracted towards this person or that. It is the outcome of our unconscious and subconscious, which is 9 times than the conscious part. We begin our journey. We feel attracted towards one another. We have to understand the deeper reasons of this togetherness. The purpose of each relation is to explore the unconscious and subconscious. There are myriad needs maybe, but it is for the purpose of the soul's journey. It requires awareness and understanding of many things. As long as you are alone, you have no problem. When two people get together, two minds, they resonate differently. You may want to have something, the other may want to have something else. Simple things, when it comes to painting the room, remember the feminine choice differs than the masculine choice. We have to remember that this association is for the continuation of soul's journey. Many adjustments are required. It requires tremendous awareness and understanding of many things. In the process of journey, each individual gets lost and fruition never happens. Minor problems comes in, they become major, and the journey is discontinued. One of the aspects in Sufi terminology is called the remembrance of Roza-e Awwal. Roza-e Awwal means the meeting of the first day. How first day when you met one another and love begins to shoot its arrow at you. Something begin to happen. No one forced anything on you. And we consider this as that we are soulmates. But slowly and slowly this begin to descend. We have to remember the first day always. If along the path we can do a meditation on the first day, share the first day moment, start repeating this as a zikr, that first day when I met you, I saw you, I felt this, and you are sharing it in all your honesty, then many things can be dissolved, because that becomes very important. The first day how you met, what had happened. There is a particular incident. Similar things happen when you come to the company of the master. You remember the first time when you meet one another. It is the physical attraction. Somewhere in wheeled in that, it is the attraction somewhere else. Sri Aurobindo, in one of his epic poems, Savitri says, on the dumb bosom of this oblivious globe, although as unknown beings we seem to meet, we are not aliens nor as strangers joined. We are bound to each other by a causeless force. What is that causeless force? That is the soul's journey. The attraction is of the within. attraction is of the soul, but we do not understand it, and we feel that the attraction is of the body, attraction is of this and that. There is a power within that knows beyond our knowing. The moment we understand this, then we can understand the nature of relationship, we can understand the nature of this togetherness, and the journey begins. If you do not understand this, then one can get lost and fruition never happens. You have to continue the journey. Transcendence beyond these require awareness. And unless transcendence happens, one cannot really understand the purpose of relationship. It is very rare that we understand the purpose of relationship. For the purpose of understanding, I divide the relationship into two categories. First is static, or the blood relation. This relationship is static in nature. This is also known as blood relation. This does not evolve or grow beyond to attain fruition. This is a kind of relationship which is infertile. Your relationship with your father, mother, brother, sister, children remain the same. As a result of the nature of such relationship, does not envisage too many variations and changes. Whereas the other type of relationship, for instance the friendship, selection of the spouse, is dynamic or self-chosen relationship. Particularly, I am referring to this kind of relationship, the self-chosen. This category includes male-female relation within the parameter of marriage, or where sex is also involved. Such relations are self-chosen. In this category also comes the friendship, as this too is self-chosen. You do not choose your parents, and parents do not choose children. It just happens. But you choose your friends. You choose your spouse. That is why I call this as dynamic relationship. The growth depends on your awareness. How aware you are, how understanding you are, you can maintain the friendship. Otherwise, disturbance begins to come. From awareness evolves your understanding, your mind, dogmas, beliefs, patterns. They come to play a dominant role in that. A Hindu falls in love with a person of a different religion, different customs. The beginning of this relationship has nothing to do with the mind. It is the journey of the heart. It is something begins to happen at the level of the heart. The journey begins. Then all these things begin to play a role. One of my friends, he is of Sikh religion. The person he is living with is Muslim. Now they want to get married. He says, I am not going to get married in a Muslim way. And the wife says, I am not going to marry in any other way. So I suggested it is better to go and marry in the court, because that has nothing to do. Here the awareness is required. We have to bend down a little bit in order to maintain the relationship. Otherwise, simply because of this mind dogma or the belief patterns, the relationship can come to an end. Husband wants to paint the house in this way, wife wants to paint in that way, problem begins. In one of the Khalil Gibran in Prophet says, Almitra comes and, Master, what about love and marriage? Master says, let there be a distance in love and marriage. What does he mean by love, distance in love and marriage? I was exploring. What does Khalil Gibran because what he wrote, sometimes these writers are touched by the higher consciousness of which they do not have any control, and they reach to that realm where even the masters don't reach. But this is not in their hand. Rabindranath Tagore in one of his plays mentioned, when I was reading that, I found that yes, this is what is Khalil Gibran meant, what is meant by distance in love and marriage. The story goes on, there is a rich girl, she owns an orchard, she is in love with a man, a boy who is poor, with scanty resources. They are deeply in love with one another. One day the boy asked the girl to get married. The girl said, it's no problem. I have an orchard. There is a river stream and a bridge. On the other side of the stream, I have my house. On the other side, I will build a similar house for you. You live in your house, I live in my house. You decorate it your way, I do it my way. Sometimes I can invite you to my house, other times you invite me. Sometimes we can sail in the stream or meet one another over the bridge. The boy said, what kind of marriage is this? This is what is meant by Khalil Gibran when he said, let there be distance in marriage. Now, this could be a bone of contention. This seems weird, but this is a fact, and because of these small things, the relationship begins to come to an end. Why can't we have two rooms? I decorate my room my way. I have my kitchen developed my way. When I am finished in my kitchen, by the time I finish, there is no dishes in the sink. Completely clean. Even if I have to go early in the morning, everything is spick and span. This may not be the habit of the other person. Either we compromise with it or overlook, then it happens slowly and slowly, the marriage begins to limp. The stronger one dominates, the other one just simply follows for certain reasons. No, there should be an understanding and awareness. You are doing this work, I will help you in clearing up the wares or dishes or something. A sharing. Now the two partners are working, bringing the livelihood. So why do women have to do all the work at home? Sharing is important. We can build the simple thing. I want a blue bed sheet. You want a white, because I have decided to have everything in my room in white color, white bed sheet. No, I want a pink color. So let us have two rooms, one room with the pink color, the other room with that. If we have resources, we have no problem. If we do not have, we have to have understanding and awareness, and that is what is very important. And it happens. But this has to be done very quickly, because right now there is tremendous energy and we can work together. By the time one reaches the age of 40, the energy begins to deplete. And then after 40, when there is a disturbance and we are not able to solve it through our awareness, then separation becomes very prominent and unavoidable. And after that, the best friend, in the beginning, who is your best friend? My spouse, my husband, my boyfriend, my girlfriend is my best friend. But does it continue right through afterwards? Afterwards, the best friend of a woman is always a woman. And a best friend of a man is always a man. And one, in particular, one who has similar problem in his marriage. Because we can share our problems with one another. Why can't your spouse remain your best friend throughout the life? But that requires understanding. Fruition of the existential bioenergy that we know as sex energy. When it is properly channeled, No one can be my best friend. I can relate it to anyone, but my best friend, my confidant is my spouse and no one else. And then it happens, you may have conflict with your brother and sister, but when the problem begins to happen, you go back to the known. Then the father says, I have told you not to go for this person. And you start agreeing, yes, father, you are right. No, we have to rely on our consciousness. And if you go and speak to the master, master will tell you the same thing. You have to remember the Rosa Awwal. First day how I met, and love begins to shoot its arrow onto us. Continuously, there is an important story that I keep on narrating again and again. And when someone asks me to bless you, and when you go to a wedding ceremony, you know, all the elderly persons who have never experienced bliss in their life, they continue to shower their blessings onto you. As if they have gained something. They have gained something in marriage, but their blessings are sought first because they are elderly persons. Have you gained anything in your life? One of my friends, when I told him that I am going to get married, would you not bless? He said, I am sorry, I have not gained anything in marriage. I cannot bless you because I haven't got anything. I do not have even an advice that I can give you. So Rosa Awwal means this particular person was very poor. And it happened somehow the other, Akbar, the king, Mughal emperor, his eyes fell on him. He felt compassion and he appointed him as a soldier in his army. But because of his dedication, he got continuously promoted from a soldier to next position, and then he became the army commander. Anytime it happens, jealousy comes, and the people became very jealous that why all the favors are being showered on this person. What is so unique about him? So they conspired. And kings are the most insecure people. The people who are in power, they feel that they are very powerful, but they are most insecure people. So they told him that every day this person locks up himself into the room and I do not know what he does. Maybe he is planning a conspiracy against you. So something has to be done for that. So king decided to do his own investigations. He made a peephole in the room and went and started watching. He saw the man came into the room. He locked the room, went to a cupboard, took out something which was wrapped in old rags. He opened it. He undressed himself, put on those old, shabbily ragged clothes. He stood up in front of the mirror in a state of supplication, prayers. Then he changed back his clothes, put the old clothes back into the cupboard, closed the cupboard. So the king, when he saw, he darted into the room. Now, if you want to remove this word darted, there is no other word. He darted in. He asked, what is this? He said, sir, when I came into your company, I was in these rags. I had nothing, simply because of your grace, simply because of your compassion, I begin to have my livelihood and have reached to this position. I am trying to remember my first day meeting with you. Masters emphasize, Sufis specifically say that you have to remember the Rosa Awwal. If you can do the zikr of Rosa Awwal, the problem that Shaitan, the cannot disturb you from your path. The basis of each relation is love, because it begins with love and its understanding is very important. When it happens, both of you are unconscious and you do not know. You may feel that this person's eyes were beautiful, but you remember the beauty of the eyes will disappear, or the face, or the way the person looks. The way the person smiles has captured me. But that smile may change and you may become familiar with it. Every day you are seeing the same thing. You will find the eyes of the beloved is like a dove. But when your shirt button breaks, and he said, what happened? Are you blind or what? You cannot see the shirt button is broken. Where the eyes have gone now? Because you have become accustomed to it again. Relate again and again. Remember the Roza Awwal. The love will continue to grow. Understanding will come. Love remains nonchalant in a static relationship. Because it is, everything is considered as granted. Nothing is new. You just accept everything as it is. Everything becomes, in a static relationship, everything is taken for granted. Love becomes nonchalant and its nature never changes. However, in dynamic relationship, love undergoes through various stages. It begins from gross and aspires to attain fruition. It is in the seed form. This you have to allow to nourish and nurture on a day-to-day basis through the remembrance of the day, first day. You must remember something that has attracted you in your spouse, continuously remembering that as a zikr, nourishes and nurtures that, and then it continues to attain fruition. It begins from gross and aspires to attain fruition. In fact, dynamic relationship is the journey of transcendence of love from baser to the precious. You have to transform all that is baser into precious. It is journey from the worldly love to love divine. At its peak, love becomes friendliness or the quality of your being. Then it does not remain a relationship anymore. The two are never separate from one another. It is this aspect of relationship that is the concern of humanity. This relationship is significant in many ways. It is not based on blood. It is your own choice. Nobody forced it onto you. You have to remember, when I made this choice, was I wrong? No. It was who directed me to that relationship? Maybe apparently your friend or somebody has directed, but it is the power within that is symbolic of God has directed you towards that person. This may never ever forget. And the moment you remember this again and again, you will realize that your relationship is getting nourished and nurtured in a unique way. It is not based on blood, yet still it is the basis of all blood relations. All blood relations evolve out of it. It is because of this communion begins with the blood relations. The children are born, the whole journey of the blood relation begins. The existential, the journey as the Shiva and Shakti, or male and female according to the Hindu aspect, Purush, the male aspect, and Prakriti, the field, the yin and yang according to the Chinese energy, is at play as the basis of this energy field. In scientific terms, we can say it is the interplay of the positive and the negative, or yin and yang energies. The entire process of evolution takes place because of this interaction between yin and yang, positive and negative. You look at the bulb that lights, because when the negative and the positive balance one another, neutralize one another, then the bulb lights. When the energy that flows into your car battery from the positive to negative and they neutralize one another, negative comes from the body, the positive comes from outside. And the two neutralize one another, the car begins to start. And once the car is started, then you can accelerate it and can continue the journey. The entire process of evolution takes place because of this interaction between the two energies. In spiritual terms, we call it as Shiva and Shakti, the male and the female, as Purush and Prakriti, the male and the female aspect. As we are entering into this realm, a few more things are necessary to be understood. Self-chosen implies two persons guided by their subconscious and unconscious states of awareness have chosen the other as a part of this relationship. This cannot be wrong when it comes to soul's journey. There is power within that knows beyond our knowing. And when it happened, you have to remember that it is God who directed you towards that person. This cannot be wrong when it comes to soul's journey. Your subconscious and unconscious is the part of total consciousness. And total consciousness, Hindus call it as Brahma, or you can call it God, or you can call it whatever name you can assign it to. But it is the whole, it is the totality. Otherwise, how can the two people living in different continents come to meet one another? Sometimes we choose our partner, choose our spouse. We don't know how it happens. When you look into how you got into an association with this person in a unique way, there was no way for you to meet this person. Had it been missed by a fraction of a second, it would have been missed. How can there be not a divine energy at play in the meeting of the two people? All relationship, Hindus say that man is an embodiment of Vishnu and woman is an embodiment of Lakshmi. And when the two are getting and entering into the marriage wedlock, it is Lakshmi. In fact, it is Lakshmi and Vishnu getting married to one another again. Because we carry that spark within us. We are made out of the same stuff that God is. We are the Noor. We are the light. Where the light comes from, the light has two aspects, the positive and the negative. In you, the positive and negative are put together. In your spouse is put together again. We have to balance our own. It is a journey of individuality again. I have to grow on my own. And through this relationship, I can grow into maturity, develop understanding. And same thing happens to the other spouse. And then it is a togetherness. This decision cannot be erroneous. Or as far as soul's journey is concerned. But sometimes the mind feels, when the problem begins to crop up, instead of trying to solve them with an understanding, with the remembrance of Rosa Awal, we say, was I stupid that I have chosen this person? Everybody thinks of that. I made a mistake that I have chosen you as my spouse. No, you are going against the divine will. This decision cannot be erroneous as far as the soul's journey is concerned. But mind cannot understand this and creates problems. The mind is ego. Soul seeks evolution from this state and it wants to attain freedom from the bondage of the body-mind mechanism. It is the subconscious and unconscious that begins this journey. In the process, you have to journey through the dark caves of the soul. And through awareness and understanding, you can transcend. And how this dark cave is created? Dark caves are created by your dogmas, religious beliefs and the mind and ego. Man, mind, intellect, buddhi, chit, memory sense and ego sense. All these create the dark caves. The moment mind comes to play, its role problem begins. This you have to understand. You have to learn to trust your initial judgment. As you traverse through these caves, many emotions, feelings, etc. emerged, and mind fails to understand this for the continuation of the journey. In the absence of understanding, we tend to abandon the one relationship, one relation, and want to take another course. Thus we remain throughout a traveler and never find a place to rest. Love is the only place where you can rest permanently, and the desert of misery, pain you experience, and in that occasional oasis of pleasure and happiness comes. To transcend beyond pain and pleasure, and thus to attain to that state of bliss, you need to understand certain things. First, be honest and true to yourself. And when you enter into a relationship with someone, then also allow the same to your partner as well. The honesty and sincerity to be true to oneself. Start dropping all deceptions, masks and faces. They have become habit. So unless you drop them consciously and deliberately, they are never dropped and therefore continue to hang around your consciousness and create the problem. Small things become bigger problems. When they arise right in the nip, you have to put them into the place. And much pain will come along this way. For example, you are going with her and you see a beautiful woman. You say to her, you are being pulled towards her beauty. Now you have to respect, this is a natural phenomenon. You can be attracted towards someone, he can be attracted to someone. Just as when you are going to the supermarket, you are attracted towards things that relate to you, the feminine. The masculine, the male gets attracted towards other things. We understand this very much. But when it comes otherwise, we do not understand. A great desire to possess have arisen in you. You are honest, you mention it. The person understands it. Not that you are going to possess her, but the desire has arisen. There is a fear in you. You are caught in two situations, whether to look at the person or not. Every woman asks her spouse, what do you like in me? Tell me. The person hesitates. No, you have to tell me what you like in me. When you saw me for the first time, what did you like in me? So she knows that this is what has attracted him when he met me. So when you are going on the street and you find someone, say, yeah, this person will certainly get attracted because of these things toward this person. But you are not honest enough. Yes, that is natural. I can get attracted towards anyone, but that does not mean I am going to abandon that relation. But again, you return home, you are angry with your spouse. He has no way to share it. So the problem begins to happen there. If you are honest, but there is lack of understanding in the other, this will create a serious problem. To appreciate and encounter such situation is quite natural. In such a situation, if you are honest, problem comes in. And if you are dishonest, that too will create a problem. The awareness is very important. Ordinarily, you feel it is better not to say such things to your spouse. Even if she catches you red-handed, still you never confess. Because she knows very well what has attracted him in me. And when something similar happens, the person is naturally bound to be attracted towards that person. You cannot deny that fact. and she will catch you many times because your eyes will show. And when you look at another person who is beautiful and attractive and suddenly a desire arises in you, you remember many times we do not finish the job completely. We are working on a project. The day has come to an end. We put the file back. So next day we have to go and fulfill our that assignment. And when you maybe on the day one, if you had stayed for 15 minutes extra, you would have finished. But when you have to begin that next day, it will take longer than 15 minutes to finish that job. Many times different kind of emotions arise in you. The history, the Hindu scriptures mentions of that. We have always have the habit of leaving the things unfinished. And unfinished things hang around our consciousness, and that is what happens, hangs around our unconscious and subconscious. It goes on in the story in Hindu incarnations, when Vishnu took an incarnation as a midget to remove the atrocities of the one of the persons. He appears as a boy in front of the king Bali. He had his daughter Ratnamala. As soon as he belonged to the demon clan Rakshas, she sees the boy coming. She felt so much of motherly affection towards that person, and she wished, a desire came to her mind, I wish I could breastfeed this child. This is natural. Then when the work began and Vishnu asked for the 3 steps of land, and the story goes on, when he could not find the space to put the 3rd foot, the king said, you put the 3rd foot on my head, and with that the atrocities will come to an end. And that was the end of that demon king. When this happened, the same daughter fell with so much of anger towards that boy, a thought came to her mind, I wish I could kill him right now. Similar things happen in our lives, in our relationship. One moment we are filled with love, next moment we are filled with so much of anger that I wish I could kill him. But understanding is important. How the 2 emotions can be lived together. If there is awareness, it is wrong for me to have the emotion, this person looks like my spouse, but it is not my spouse. I may be thinking that she is my spouse. You are separated from your spouse. She has gone away for holidays. Everything that you open your cupboard, everything reminds you of your spouse. All of a sudden you see a person that reminds you of a spouse, you want to go and give her a hug. If you give her a hug, what will happen? You are thinking that she resembles your spouse, but does she think the same way for you? You will be welcomed with a slap. So you have to understand, although this person looks like that, but it is not. It is the unfulfilled desire. I am remembering my spouse. That's why this desire is arising. Awareness is very important. Then the 2 conflicting thoughts will not be there. The person that who you met on the street, maybe because you remember all the everyone is made out of the same stuff. You carry the same light within you. It's made out of the humus, the body is made out of the humus, the elements, and the consciousness or the light is put into it. So the all feminine aspects belong to one category, male aspect belong to one category. So they may have resemblance, residual. When your car is not starting, your battery is running down, what do? You take the positive charge from the other battery to activate your battery. Had the two batteries been separate, then you cannot get the charge. They carry the same element. You take the positive charge from the other battery. So when you come to the company of the master, you are taking the positive charge from the master, from the sheikh. He constantly gives you, nourishes and nurtures and charges your battery so that you can continue your life. Your car will continue for a longer period of time. Then your battery begins to discharge again. You go, unless and until you develop your own process that your battery does not get discharged at all. If that does not happen automatically, then you have to rely on someone whose battery is always charged. Connect, you have to connect to that source in order for your battery to get charged. Just as when your battery is discharged and car is not tumbling, you connect it to the other battery. That is the association with the one who has known, association with the sheikh, association with the master. At every moment, unconscious continues to play its role. Remember, in 1976, I was working on my books on economics. So there was, after each chapter, I was to give certain questions, problems, and then the solution answers to those. But it was difficult. That time, the resources, the financial resources were scanty. I had to save every single penny in order to arrange for my transport as well as the books. So that day when I was not getting the solution, I went to the cafeteria. I ordered certain things, but while waiting to get a line flashed. It is for the heart to suggest our problems and it is for intellect to solve them. Now later on I changed that. It is the unconscious that to create the problems, unconsciousness in us to create the problems as we understand. Because when something surfaces from the dark cave, we consider this as a problem. But it is not a problem. It is a, you can make it a problem or you can use it as a, you can cross over this as a way to transcend beyond this problem. And when you transcend beyond this problem, you gain more courage, you gain more confidence in you, and it is awareness to solve them. The moment it happened, I said, "Eureka, I have found it." I left everything, I rushed, and then I continued working from 7 in the morning until 6 in the evening without a break, nothing to eat or anything. And I got the answers to all those problems that was there. So it is for the unconscious part in you to suggest the problems, but there is a light part in you. You are connected to that light, and that light can bring that in the form of awareness, can sort out all the problems. It is natural for such situations to arise. To do anything is possible only when it has arisen, not before that. You do not know whether there is a problem or not when it surfaces. Only then you have to use in your intelligence to overcome that. But it has arisen now. You can repress it, but you cannot do anything else. Even if the woman or the spouse catches you, you would like to pretend that no, it was not that. You are looking at something else. Do not be untrue. Then you will be vulnerable to pain. And start by being vulnerable to pain, because everybody wants to open for pleasure and nobody wants pain. And the arithmetic is, if you open to pain, only then you can attain to the happiness. It is the other side of the coin. Pain and pleasure, happiness and sorrow are two sides of the same coin. You have to flip over the coin. They are directly proportional to one another. If you are not open to pain, you cannot open to happiness. Remember the pain that a woman undergoes in the process of delivering a child. If she does not undergo that pain, the happiness of the childbirth will not be there. And in that childbirth, she gives not only a birth to a child, but she gives birth to herself. Now she is no more a woman, instead she is a mother. She gives a birth to motherhood. Motherhood means a caring, a different kind of a quality. In one of the Hindu aspect, I remember that a woman asks that a blessing from a sage, that I may be blessed with 100 children, sons. The sage says, yes, you will be blessed with 100 sons and your husband will be the 101st son. That relationship comes in. If you are not open to pain, you cannot you are not open to pleasure as well. That is why there are so many people, each hankering for pleasure, but everybody is getting the pain because they have taken the wrong step from the very beginning. Let her also be true. Allow the truth to happen. Do not force her to repress. If a thought comes, sometimes it happens. The children are always have something or the other which they do not like in their parents. But we never allow them to express themselves. I am allowing her to express herself. If she does not express herself, her feelings, whether it is good or bad, they will remain in the subconscious and will create a problem. And she will not be able to have a harmonious relation with her spouse. It is very important. If a thought comes to your mind, express it. This is what catharsis is. When you accumulate and there are too many toxins accumulated into your body and there is no way, the doctor tells you, the sicknesses comes into you, then now there are systems, there are medicines that help you to remove that toxins from that body. Catharsis is that mechanism to remove the toxins from the body. There is a particular Sufi, nobody knows his name, but he lived in a place called Jibar. That's why he came to be known as Jibar, and we have a Sufi meditation called Jibrish. He used to sit down under the open sky, and whatever used to come to his mind, he will say it. Pleasant, unpleasant, good and bad, he used to say, look at the sky and say it. It was catharsis. The words do not form. It's just, that is why it is called gibberish. Nobody understands what you are saying. And it is one of the important meditations, gibberish as a meditation. If you cannot do that, you can do the gibberish meditation. You don't need to use the words, anything that comes to your mind. Only the sounds are necessary to be created. So gibberish, you can use the words as well as you can use sound. So just start opening by and by, and there is no need to do anything at all. And you don't need to do all of it. All of it and too much at one time, because that can destroy the relationship. Go in small doses and too slowly and slowly, Just show a little part of your real face and not the whole face at one time. By and by, let the mask slip. Then one day, you can remove it totally. You can use gibberish almost every day. At a certain hour, you can sit down and gibberish, just as when you come home, you take a shower before taking a bath, before taking a meals, that to remove the all the odor, all this, anything that accumulates on the body. But do we have anything to do when the dust gathers on the mind? No, we do not have anything to do. We try to hide it. Gibberish is the way, gibberish is the soap, the detergent that you can use to remove all that gathers onto the mind. And when this opening brings pain, you see that it has also brought a totally a new quality of pain. The pain of the childbirth is a totally different kind of pain. It is very refreshing. It is painful, yet it is cleansing. Painful, yet it is worthwhile. It brings something. It brings integration and sometimes clarity too. And it makes you more and more aware. Pain always makes people aware. When you consciously go into pain, there is every possibility that it can. You could have every possibility that you could have avoided it, but you went into it consciously. The happiness is bound to happen. Remembering the Roza-e Awwal, remembering to be authentic, using gibberish as a meditation, as a part of catharsis, is important as far as relationship is concerned. It happens always like this. Almost in all the relations, there are no moments of silence between the couples. When you are going through your courtship, you do not want to talk to one another. You just hold hands and sitting down quietly and enjoying each other's company. But when husbands and wives do not talk, it is considered something is wrong. Why are you not talking? Because things have changed. We have taken one another for granted. It is your journey, a soul's journey. You have to look into how to find the ways and means. If it is difficult to find a solution, you can seek the assistance from the Sheikh. He is always open. He will never want any relation to be severed, and he will never want anything to be left incomplete. And only when it completes, then your dependence on the male-female will disappear. You will reach a point where you do not need the male and you do not need the female. Then, in the next life, if there is any, you do not need the need for the spouse, or need for the any entering into relationship. This is the way we have to look into the relationship. Go beyond this through our awareness, understanding the points that I had mentioned, remembering the first day you're meeting. When there is, just as when you come home after a long day drive, you take a shower before you're going to do anything, do a gibberish every day. At least once in a week, doing gibberish is very important. It cleanses all those unwanted things and makes you fresh once again.